மண்ணே ததர்ப்பிதா மனோ வசுனோ ஹிதார்த்திய பிராணங் புனாதி சகுலங் நது பூரிமான். This verse we have been discussing, you know. So, Vipra. Vipra means one who is fully conversant with Vedic knowledge. He is called Vipra. For spiritual elevation, there are gradual evolutionary stages. Vipra stage is just before becoming a qualified Brahmin. That is called Vipra. The first stage, by birth, everyone is Shudra. Shudra means affected by the miseries of this world. He is Shudra. Shochati. The material condition is full of anxiety. So anyone who is full of anxiety is a Shudra. This is the... So if you analyze the present society, that who is not anxiety, full of anxiety? Nobody will say that I am not full of anxiety. I have got so many anxieties. So that means he is a Shudra. Kalo Shudra Sammava. In this age, every one is Shudra. That is concluded. A Brahmin is not afraid, is not anxious, because he is dependent on God. He knows that I am surrendered unto God completely, and He is all powerful. Therefore, I have no anxiety. Just like a small child, he has no anxiety. Why? Because he is completely dependent on the parents. He knows confidently that in any danger, oh, my mother is there. As soon as he feels there is some danger, mother, that's all. Finished. Similarly, one who is completely confident that the Supreme Father is there, he is. Protect me, give me protection. So he has no anxiety. Narayana parasadvena kutaschana vibhati. When one is fully confident about God consciousness or Krishna consciousness, he is not afraid. Not even afraid of death, because he knows that he has no death, he is eternal. So, to come to this platform of confidence or Krishna consciousness, there is training. That training is called Vidhi Marga, regulative principles, following the regulative principles. So, this whole Varnasram system, Vedic system, the different caste, Brahmin, Kshatriya, Vaishya, Shudra, Brahmachari, Grihastha, Vanaprastha, Sannyas, they are very scientifically designed to elevate one gradually to the standard of no fear, fearfulness-less, no more fear, confidence. So Vipra means just the previous stage of becoming completely Brahmin. Janmana jayanti sudra. By birth everyone is born a sudra. Samaskara bhavidya. When he goes to the spiritual master, and the spiritual master initiates him, at that time his second birth is there, dija. Dija, the births are called also dija, because they get twice birth. Once they come as egg, the form of birth is the egg, and then when they come out from the egg and the cell, break the cell and come out, that is real life. Similarly, we are in the egg, within the cell of ignorance. So, when we come out from the cell of ignorance, that is our second birth. The first birth is by father and mother, and the second birth is by the spiritual master and Vedic knowledge. There is also mother. The Vedic knowledge is mother, and the spiritual master is the father. So, samskarat bhavidija, the spiritual master trains the student gradually. That is called initiation. That is called dija. The janmana jayanti sudra, by birth, by the father and mother, everyone is sudra. It doesn't matter where he takes his birth. Not that. Only India, they are Brahmin, Kshatriya, Vaishya, Shudra, everywhere. Chaturvarna maya system guna karma vibhavasa. In the Bhagavad Gita you find that these four systems of social division, Brahmin, Kshatriya, Vaishya, Shudra, they are all over the universe. Not that, don't think that it is in India, everywhere. So samskara bhavidija. By reformation, by following the regulatory principle of how to elevate oneself to the knowledge of Brahma, that is called samskara. There are 10 kinds of samskaras, reformatory. This Vedic system is very scientific system to elevate the humankind to the highest perfection of life. So, samskarat bhavetija. Then, when the samskar is given, when is the spiritual master sees that this boy is now competent to study Vedas, that requires qualification. A sudra is not allowed to study Vedas. There is a restriction. Sometimes they think injustice. The why sudras? That is modern convention. Actually, that is very nice. What a sudra can understand Vedas? To the sudras, a different type of knowledge, just like the same thing, that the 2 plus 2 in the lower class is different from the 2 plus 2 in the higher mathematics. So sudra cannot understand. So one has to become Brahmin. Vipra at least. Dija. Twice birth by initiation. Then he is allowed to study. Then he will be able to understand the language of it. It is not injustice that sudras are not. Just like, I do not know what is the system in your country, but in India, one who is not a graduate is not allowed to study law. If anyone wants to study law, if he wants to enter into the law college, then he must be a graduate, first of all, at least B.A. Otherwise he cannot. So if somebody says it is injustice, why? Everyone should. So everyone cannot understand. Similarly, without being initiated by a proper spiritual master, nobody can understand, because it's not like that. You purchase a book, the Bhagavad Gita or Bhagavad, and study at home, and you learn. Oh, it is not possible. Just like, simply by purchasing some medical books and study at home, you cannot become a doctor, medical man. That is not possible. Neither you can become a lawyer. The books are available in the market. But that is not the process. You have to enter yourself in an institution, take lessons from the professors, must attend lecture classes, 75% at least, then you are allowed to sit in the examination. So, the gradual process, first birth is Shudra. Anyone, it doesn't matter. Even if he is born of a Brahmin father, he is considered a Shudra. So, then by initiation, he becomes Bijva, second birth. Then he is allowed to study the Vedic literatures, and when he is conversant with the studies of Vedic literature, he is called Vipra. And when one has become a Vipra, that because that is the just previous stage of becoming a Brahmin, he acquires 12 kinds of qualities. Sattva, Sama, Dama, Tidikha. The first quality is truthfulness. The second quality is controlling the senses, controlling the mind. Sama, Dama, Tidikha, to be very tolerant. Arjava, very simple, full of knowledge, full of atheism. So many qualities, these qualities are mentioned. So, here Prahlad Maharaj says, Vipra Dishara Guna Juta. When one is a Vipra, that means he has got all the good qualities, material good qualities. He is truthful, he is conversant with the science of religion, he knows what is God, what is Brahma, he is self-controlled, he is not sensual, so many good qualities. So Prahlad Maharaj says that even one has attained the stage of becoming a Vipra, and he has acquired all the good qualities required for becoming a Vipra. But if he is lacking one quality, what is that? Vipradhi saragana jita dharavinda nama padharavinda vimukha. But he is averse to God consciousness, the Krishna consciousness. He has got all the good qualities. He has studied Veda. But if he is not God conscious, padharavinda, Aravinda Nava, Pada Aravinda. Aravinda Nava, Nava means this narrow. And Aravinda means lotus. You know that the creation is made by the navel of Vishnu, the first sprouting of the lotus flower life planet, and there is Brahma. And he creates other things. So therefore, Aravinda Nava, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, whose navel has a lotus flower, Aravinda Nava. And Pada Aravinda, and it is, feet is also just like lotus. Aravinda, Aravinda Nava, Aravinda Pada. That means Supreme Personality of Godhead. So he Vipra, a qualified, person with all good qualities, material person, if he is lacking this simple quality, that he is not conversant with the science of God. Vimukha is not very serious to understand what is God. That is the position. Now at the present moment, everyone is highly educated to the material standard, but they have no knowledge what is God. So even they become vipra, because they are lacking this knowledge. Prahlad Maharaj says that a person, a dog eater who has God consciousness is better than him. Sapachang Varishta. Sapachang means a person who is born in the family of dog eaters. Sapachang Varishta. Manne tadarpita mana vasane hitartha. There is description. Maunam, mauna vijnana santusha. Satyatika Disharguna. Jadva Samodamastaposang Kanti Ajaba Viraktataha Mauna Vijnana Santusa Satyatike Disharguna. The 11, 12 qualities, good qualities, is described in the Vedic literature. What is this? That Sama. Somehow I see equilibrium of the mind. Dhamma. Dhamma means controlling the senses. Sama, dhamma, stapa, austerity. Tapa means, from tap of heat. Just like this heat is not tolerable. I require the fan. So tapa means to accept voluntarily some physical trouble. That is called tapa. There are many sages who, during summer, they will burn fire all sides and meditate. There is already high temperature, 112 degrees in India. Sometimes 180 degrees, and still they have fire all sides, yes, and they are meditating, not disturbed. So this is called voluntarily, tapa. And in winter season, when the temperature is 40 degrees, 50 degrees, of course not below zero, anyway, he goes to the water and deep into the water, simply keeping the mouth up, he meditating. So there are some senior processes for tapasya. Oh, so this is one of the good quality. But in this age, it is very difficult to undergo such voluntary tribulations. For realization, self-realization, meditation is not possible in this age. Therefore, the Vedic injunction is that you simply chant Hare Krishna. Hare Nama, Hare Nama, Hare Nama, Iva Kevalam. You don't have to take any botheration. In whatever position you are, you just try to concentrate your mind to hear the sound Hare Krishna. Best type of meditation. Because it is not possible to acquire all these qualities. Tapa. The samadama tapa souchang. Souchang means cleanliness. Hygienic principle. To take bath thrice, at least once, really, daily. Therefore, to keep it, no hair is better. There is no question of moisture in the hair. And those who have got big hair, they cannot take daily bath. But if you keep your bad headed, there is no trouble. So chang. So bathing is required, taking bath daily. So chang. And kanti. Kanti means toleration. Because this world is full of miseries. And you have to execute Krishna consciousness with this, in this condition. Krishna advised in the Bhagavad Gita, Arjuna, because the topic was on the body. So Arjuna says, accepting that the soul is immortal and it never dies. Still, if some relative dies, we are feel pain. Is it not a fact? Krishna says, yes, it is a fact. Even if I know that my son is dead, my son is not dead, the soul of my son is departed from this body to another body, so there is no cause of anxiety, he has got another body, but still I feel, oh, my son, for the body. Because I am accustomed to love my son by the body. So this concession should be allowed. If somebody is crying, that does not mean he is a fool, but it is material affection. So Krishna advises that this kanti, titikha, toleration. How? Toleration? Sidosna sukhadukkhada. Just like we tolerate very severe cold. There is no use fighting and howling. Oh, there is so much cold, so much cold. Oh, you have to tolerate. You cannot fight. Matras prasastu sita kaunteya sitasna sukhadukkhada agama apayina anitya tan vilikha svarata. He advised, yes, I understand. There are pains and pleasures like that. But they have to be tolerated. You cannot be disturbed. You have to execute your business of Krishna consciousness. If there is any trouble, you must know no trouble or no happiness exists because this is material. It has come, it will go. So, for the time being, don't be mad after happiness and don't be mad after miseries. Agama paina, they come and go. Just like this. Nowadays, it is very hot. This season will change. And again will be disturbed by cold. So disturbance will continue. Either heat or cold due to this material body, matras purusha, due to this keen attachment. So we have to tolerate. So one who is actually vipra, he is tolerant. He is not disturbed by this material tribulations, kanti, ajava. Simple, very simple. Duplicity is very bad qualification for spiritual advancement. We have got a tendency for cheating, everyone, conditioned soul. That should be minimized. This is called harjava. Harjava means saralata. And viraktata, detachment. The whole system is detachment from matter. If we are too much attached, why too much? Even if we are slightly attached to this material life, then we have to accept this body, any kind of body, this body or that body. There are 8,400,000 types, 4,000 types of bodies. So long we'll have a slight attachment for this material enjoyment, sense enjoyment. We'll have to accept a certain type of body. Therefore, this vairagya, viraktata, detachment from matter, is the whole basic principle of spiritual realization. So, this Krishna consciousness process is simultaneously detachment from matter and attachment for Krishna. It is so nice system. It is so nice, just like we are to increase our love for Krishna. The proportionately we increase our love for Krishna, we decrease our love for matter. So I have got a spirit to love that I cannot stop. Similarly, there are many examples. Just like a boy or a girl, he or she increases the love for another boy, another girl, he decreases the love for another boy. This is natural. Similarly, if you increase your love for Krishna, then you decrease your love for nonsense. So Vairagya, this detachment from matter is automatically done. We have got the propensity to love something, at least a dog, if not God. So, if we turn our face to the loving attachment to Krishna, then Param Dishchani Vartate, that is stated in the Bhagavad Gita. Param Dishchani Vartate. If you are given better thing, just like in children, he is loving something, but if you give him something better, something red, he is attached immediately. He gives up the old thing and takes up the red. So you cannot. The jnana system, the yoga system, is by force they are trying to detach. That is not possible. It may be possible for the time being. Just like Vishwamitra, a great sage. These are the historical references. He was a very king, great king, and he wanted to realize self, and he began to meditate in the forest alone, as it is, the yoga system. He must be in secluded life. He must make his seat in a very sacred place and sit in this posture. There are, so he followed everything completely, perfect joy. But as soon as Indra saw that this man is performing a great yoga system, he may not acquire my position. So he sent one beautiful girl, Manoka, to entice him. So, she came, she began to dance before her, and there was twinkling sound. At once, his meditation broke. And she was very beautiful coming from heaven, so he became attached, and the woman became pregnant, then she got a child, Shakuntala, and then Vishwamitra came to his senses, though I left my kingdom, I came to forest for meditation, again I am going to be another kingdom. So he decided that I shall go out. So Manoka tried to entice him, why you shall go? Just see how nice girl you have got. Just see, there is a picture, perhaps you have seen. And Vishwamitra is doing like this. Don't saw me anymore. Let me go. Of course, he was very much advanced. He could go. But this allurement is always there. But Krishna is so beautiful and so nice, that if you increase your love for Krishna, then You have no more any attachment for anything, any beautiful thing of this world. Param nishtani vartat. Just like Krishna, all these gopis, they came to Krishna giving up their all engagements. They were engaged in loving children, some of them were engaged in serving their husband, or unmarried girls, they are engaged to serving her father, her brother. But as soon as Krishna blew his flute, they came all. So similarly, if our attachment becomes very nice, very mature for Krishna, then this virakta or detachment for material things will automatically happen. But that is required, virakta. And mauna. Mauna. Mauna means don't talk. Great. This is also very good qualification. Because generally when we talk, we simply talk nonsense. That's all. We shall sit together, some friends or family, some useless talks we shall go on for hours together. But if you are called to talk about Krishna or Bhagavad Gita or Bhagavad, this philosophy, nobody will come. Better not to talk. It is better not to talk than to talk nonsense, foolish. So, generally, we are accustomed to talks, enjoy foolish talks, which has no meaning. Neither any benefit for this material world, neither any benefit for spiritual world. If we are, of course, gaining something material benefit, just like businessmen talk, they talk seriously if there is any profit. Otherwise, the secretary says, Mr. Satan says, has no time to see you. That is also some good, because time is so valuable. So why should we talk nonsense? So that is also very good qualification, if we don't talk nonsense. Either you talk about Krishna or don't talk. That is called mauna. If there is no subject matter for talking on the subject of Krishna, then it is better not to talk. But we have got very nice engagement, we can talk Hare Krishna. If you have no other engagement, then we have got these bees, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Gitan, day and night, 24 hours gone. This is called mauna. And vijnana. Vijnana means perfect knowledge. What is that perfect knowledge? Perfect knowledge means to know Krishna. Jasmin vijnate sarvam evam vijnatam bhavanti. The Vedic injunction is, if you can understand the Supreme, then you understand the whole thing. Because Supreme is the whole, absolute. Just like if you can understand 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 8, 9, 0, then you can understand the whole mathematics. Because what is mathematics? 1, 2, 3, 4, 3, 4, 1, 2, just like. That's all. The same 9 figures, that's all. Similarly, the Veda says, jasmin vijnate sarvam evam vijnatam bhavanti. If you simply try to understand the Supreme Absolute Truth, that is the purpose of Vedas. And it is confirmed in the Bhagavad Gita also, Veda ishta sadvai aham eva vedam. What is the use of studying Vedas? What is the use of studying this Bhagavad to understand Krishna? That's all. So here we say that maunam vijnana santosha. Santosha, this is the result. If you are perfectly knowledge of Krishna, then you are satisfied. satisfied. Just means sthite guru napi dukkhena na vicharate. In the Bhagavad Gita it is said, jaglabhya cha puranglabhanga mannatenadikam tatha. If one attains to the perfection of Krishna consciousness, then he has no more to understand anything. Janglabdha chapra. He does not want any more profit in any way. He thinks that I am completely. Just means sthite. And the taste is that if one is situated in Krishna consciousness, then guru nāpi dukkhena. Because the world, this material world, we are always in trouble. So, a person situated in Krishna consciousness is not troubled at all, even if he is put into very trying circumstances. Guru nāpi dukkhena. This is the test. That is called santosha and satya, truthfulness, astikya. Astika means belief, faith. Faith in scripture, faith in God, that is called faith. This is faith. And when that faith is very much concentrated, then one can understand Krishna. Vishya, Shakti, Sudhira, Nishchar, Krishna, Bhakti, Kaila, Sarva, Karma, Krita. This is called strong faith or firm faith. What is that firm faith? When one is convinced that if I am Krishna conscious, then all my duties will be perfect. And that is the fact. Saṃsiddhi harito sara has several times spoken in this meeting that let everyone be engaged to his specific duty. It doesn't matter what it is. But if you want to see that whether your function is perfected, then you have to test it whether by your activities Krishna is satisfied. Saṃsiddhi haritosanam sānuṣṭhitasya dharmasya saṃsiddhi haritosanam. So this santosha. If you think that Krishna is satisfied, how you can know Krishna is satisfied? Jasya prasādāt bhagavat prasādā. If you can satisfy your spiritual master, then you should know that Krishna is satisfied. Jasya prasādāt bhagavat prasādā. So if you are fortunate enough to have a bona fide spiritual master, and if you can satisfy him, then you know that you are satisfied Krishna. This is the process. So he shall talk next week. Yes. Any question? No question? You have understood everything? Yes. No, Vipra, because he is studying. Vipra means one who is engaged in the studies of Vedas. That is, Virupathad Bhavit Vipra. So if he is studying Vedas, then must be qualified with all the good qualities. Because just like Bhagavad Gita, it is said that These are the good qualities. So study means to accept the instruction. Study does not mean simply to become a bookworm. No. Study means to apply practically in life what you learn from the Vedas. So if anyone is seriously studying, then naturally he is qualified with all the good qualities. Yes. No, you can that in the material world there are three qualities: the quality of goodness, the quality of passion, the quality of ignorance. These three qualities are working. We see varieties in this material world due to these interaction of these three qualities. So, there are varieties of men. Some of them are in good qualities, some of them are in quality of passion, some of them are in the quality of ignorance. Therefore, they have got different types of faith also. Not that your faith or my faith may be the same. Because you may be in the quality of goodness, I may be in the quality of passion or ignorance. So faith is according to the particular quality of the person who is professing that faith. The sattvic faith, the faith in goodness, that is faith in Brahma, the Supreme. That is called goodness, Brahminical faith. And above this is sattvic. Sattvic means goodness. So goodness in the material world, even goodness is sometimes contaminated with tinges of passion and ignorance. That from the material world, nothing can be in pure goodness. So one has to transcend the goodness platform of this material world and come to the platform of pure goodness, Shuddha Satta, where there is no more contamination of passion and ignorance. That platform is called God consciousness or Krishna consciousness. Well, when one has got faith in God, he must have the necessary activities. Otherwise, what kind of faith it is? Just like if I say that I have faith in you, but I don't trust you. So what kind of faith I have got? See, if I say, my dear friend, I have faith in you, and if you want me to do something, I don't do it. If I say, how can I do it? Then what kind of faith that is? So this sort of faith is not required. Faith means real faith. So whenever there is real faith, there is activity also. That is faith. When there is real Krishna consciousness, God consciousness, then there is activity for pleasing the God. Simply, I believe in God simply for exacting things from God, there is a different fight of faith. That is in the lowest stage. Just like a small child, he has got faith. But if a learned, educated child, he has got different faith. Oh, my father, my mother, they have done so much for us. He wants to repay. He wants to oblige the father. That is also another faith. The same faith. So, somebody is trying, oh God, give us our daily bread. This is also faith. But somebody is trying how to please God. He is not asking because he knows that if God is Father, then he is supplying bread to animals, to birds and bees. Why not to me? So my bread is already guaranteed. So let me serve the Father. This is hard type of faith. Why shall I ask? Well, then my Father, if he is Father, then he has already made arrangements for my eating. That is natural. Does it mean that every day the child asks Father, Mother, Mother, Father, give me my bread? Well, the Father is already preparing bread for you. He'll call you. But he is lacking the faith. He is asking. Another is not asking, he is confident. The Father will give me my bread. Now let me serve my Father. This is hard type of faith. So the faith, there are different standards of faith. One faith is trying to exact, and one faith is trying to give everything. So there are two types of faith. So which one is best, better? Anyone can judge. Just like Arjuna. In the beginning, he had faith in Krishna. He said, Krishna, please give me instruction. I am not talking anymore as friend. I accept you as my spiritual master. See, he had faith, good faith. Otherwise, how he accepted Krishna as spiritual master. But that faith in the beginning and in the last faith, after learning Bhagavad Gita, he says, Krishna, by your grace, I have got my memory. That means, in the beginning I was thinking that I should give more importance to my grandfather and my teacher and my family. But I have learned that my only duty is to serve you. Therefore, whatever you say, I'll do. This is another thing. The same man, the same Krishna, in the beginning, one faith, and at the end, another faith. So, beginning faith is that God, understanding God. But unfortunately at the present moment they don't believe in God. So there is no question of faith. They have lost all faith. This is the condition of the present society. What to speak of this faith or that faith? They have no faith. They have lost all faith, just like animal. Animal has no faith in God. That is the distinction between human being and animal. The animal has no faith. But in human society, there is a kind of faith, either it is Christian faith, or Hindu faith, or Buddhist faith, or Mohammedan faith. But when we give up this faith, Then how? Position is just like animal. The present society is just like animal. They have no faith. What to speak of this faith or that faith? That is the position. They simply utter sense enjoyment, that's all. Don't you see? The Pope says that it is not good, it is not God's law that you should use contraceptive method. But they are so mad at that sense enjoyment, they say, oh, we don't care for your innocence. You see? How much they have lost their faith. So at the present moment, it is very difficult position. No faith at all. No good qualification. Rāva bhaktasya kuto mahadugunam. Oh, their education, their scientific advancement, their so-called civilization, don't you see? Everyone is expected to have national feeling, but the postal strike, mail strike went on for 20 days, the whole nation become disturbed and harassed. Why? They want their money. What is it? Go to your national feeling, go to hell. He pays, then he what? So nobody has any faith, simply as faith in sense gratification, that's all. You satisfy my senses, then you are very good. Otherwise, go to hell. That's all. This is the position. And therefore, they are denying the topmost head of Catholic Church. You don't care for your instruction because they have become faithless. And that is not their fault. It is fault of the heads of the churches. They did not teach them properly. They were satisfied simply by money, that's all. They did not try to teach them. Now, what is the use of teaching? They have gone out of hand. The same thing, if you want to bend bamboo, do it while it is green. And when it is dry, it is not possible. So now the whole society is faithless, godless, very precarious condition. So this process, our process, we don't impose any difficult rules and regulations. Please come here and chant with us and dance with us. At least there is no loss on your part. If you think there is no gain, but at least there is no loss. So I should request you to come and join with us in our kirtan. Then everything gradually will be clear. Any other question? Don't care whether it is palatable to others or not. In social formality, you can see that that has happened actually, because the Pope, he was not strong enough in the beginning, because some other Pope, he thought it may be unpalatable. He did not speak the truth. Now, the other Pope is speaking the truth, they are not accepting. But from the very beginning, the priest should have priest in every church. dawn. My dear Christian brothers, you cannot use this contraceptive method. You are never told any charges. They are satisfying their fees, that's all. Everywhere, not only in the Christian world, in the Hindu and Christian, they don't care for any rules and regulations anymore. But the professed, I am Christian, I am Hindu, I am Mohammedan,